At this point, I would like to welcome everyone, family, friends, to this very, very special occasion. Marriage, the wedding ceremony, James and Danielle. We'd like to request that everyone please turn off or at least silence their cell phones or anything else which may be making noise. And at this point, we're going to have a procession. First, the bridegroom is going to be coming to the canopy, which symbolizes his home, known as the chuppah. And then there'll be the procession, when finally the bride herself will be brought into the home of the bridegroom, when they will officially be married. This time, we're going to ask the bridegroom to go to the back to check before the bride actually comes to make sure that indeed she is who she's supposed to be, that it's Danielle that knows, and that there are no mistakes, no switcheroos. If you remember the book of Genesis, when Jacob married Rachel and Leah. His intention was to marry Rachel. Now, all present company excluded, he had a father-in-law who was not one you would wish on anyone. And perhaps that's where all the in-law jokes begin from. His father-in-law made a switch and presented him with Rachel instead of Leah. Well, from then on, many weddings have the custom that the groom goes to check out, and when he's the one who veils the bride to make sure she is in fact his. So at this point, we're going to have the bridegroom go to the back and veil the bride. It also has very deep meaning that this is their encounter on an external level. They meet face to face. But then later on, of course, comes the very intimate relationship, which is only to be done between husband and wife. And that leads to a very happy family, with God's help, the children. So this is the start of it. This is the external face-to-face meeting and bonding on the day of their wedding. And then God bestows upon them his blessings for all good things. Is it her? Thumbs up. Okay. We're ready to proceed. Everyone may be seated. I'm going to keep my remarks relatively brief, about 7 minutes or so. I want to explain a few things which some of you may be wondering. For the most part, most of us have been to weddings, maybe different types of weddings, maybe all the same. I feel very honored, very privileged, and I think that everyone here should feel the same. This is a very, very special wedding, aside for a very special couple, the bridegroom, the bride. For those that know them, I've had the privilege to know James for a while, and then he was kind enough to bring Danielle over to our house, our home in Chicago, to get meet her personally. Very, very special people. Aside from that, James, as many people know, is not necessarily your run-of-the-mill fellow. He thinks, he inquires. And I think that that's one of the things that Danielle appreciates in him. His sincerity, his search for truth. So if he decided that he would like to make a life together with Danielle, that means that she is a true wife and a true woman and a true bride. So that's something very special. And for her to choose him means that she is someone who can see beyond the surface, and she can see that when someone wants truth and essence, that's something that one should go for. So in my humble opinion, they both made a very wise choice. Now the B'nai Noach. B'nai Noach, some of you may have heard by now. It's a term, literally it means the sons, the descendants of Noah. Technically speaking, literally speaking, every single human being on the face of the earth, all of mankind, are in fact B'nai Noach, sons and daughters of Noah. Because after the flood, all the descendants to this very day, any human being is a direct descendant of Noah. Now, some 3,500 years ago, after the great flood of Noah, God Almighty revealed himself at Mount Sinai when he gave the Torah, the law, to the Jewish people. And at that point, he had given the responsibility, he commanded Moses, that not only is he giving the Torah for the Jewish people, but there is a requirement, there's an obligation, that every single human being on the face of the earth has to believe in God and in one God, and to serve him. No religion, godliness. It's not a religion. Maybe, literally, it would be called that. And there's a set of 7 laws. Each one of these 7 incorporate and include many, many laws, many, many details. With these basic 7 laws that any civilized country, for the most part, keeps anyway. But a very important factor is that you keep them because God said so to Moses. That's basically, in a nutshell, what the B'nai Noach people are. That they've accepted this. This is a way of life. Now, one of the 7 mitzvot B'nai Noach, and you can actually see them on all the tables, there's a list of what they are, very, very brief, and then you have the cards, and you have one card standing up in the middle of each table. One of them is not to commit adultery. To be loyal and faithful. To be married, a man to a woman. That excludes many, many things, and there are many prohibitions. Whenever a man and a woman get married, they are actually fulfilling that commandment. So here, James has made an undertaking. He has made an undertaking to be loyal, to be faithful to his wife. Danielle has done the same. She has made a loyal commitment to be loyal and faithful to her husband, James. The two of them together, with God's blessings, with his help, are going to have a great life together, tremendous success. When God first created the world on the 6th day, the last day of creation, he created Adam, man. And then, from man, he created, I don't feel comfortable using the word Eve, I'm going to call her Chava. He created Chava. Chava was physically a part of Adam. From then on, any true couple are really one entity. So until now, these two lovely people were walking around, in essence, only half a person. He was incomplete. She is not.